One of the big early realizations was that elements had to combine to form compounds in certain whole number ratios. You couldn't have a fraction of an atom. You couldn't have multiple fractions of an atom. You can't have 1.5 oxygens. And also, it turns out that there's times where you'll have two hydrogens and two oxygens, or times where you'll have two hydrogens and one oxygen. But you're really not going to find one hydrogen and two oxygens. There's only certain ratios that are really going to be possible, or maybe I should better say, are commonly possible. There's always going to be exotic scenarios where we can force something to happen that nature is not too happy with, but those aren't going to be very typical. Now, if we were to take water and hydrogen peroxide, and we were to figure out how much oxygen and hydrogen are in each of them, we'd find that in 10 grams of water, we're going to have 8.9 grams of oxygen. And that water is going to contain 1.1 gram of hydrogen. And if we were to compare the ratio of the two, we're going to get this ratio that's just about 8. So it's 8 times more heavy for oxygen versus hydrogen. If we do the exact same calculation for hydrogen peroxide, we'd have 9.4 grams of oxygen for every 0.6 grams of hydrogen whenever we have 10 grams total. So you can see that really we're talking about effectively the percent weight that we have there. Now, that ratio for hydrogen peroxide ends up being 15.9, just about 16. And interestingly enough, that's going to be double the ratio for hydrogen peroxide. Now, that just seems like it's a neat number maybe, but let's actually look at the units and the chemicals that we're talking about, the atoms, in order to really see exactly what that's telling us. We're saying here we have 7.9 grams of oxygen for each 1 gram of hydrogen. In other words, it's going to be 8 times heavier for the amount of oxygen versus hydrogen. When we get down to hydrogen peroxide, it's going to be double that weight for oxygen versus hydrogen. That was really the big thing that unlocked it for them. From that, they were able to say, well, that means that hydrogen peroxide must have twice as many oxygens as water does. And from that, they were able to infer, you know, once they knew the formula of water, that hydrogen peroxide must be H2O2. But that's something that's kind of neat. The proportions of the elements in a compound can always be expressed by some whole number ratio. And we can't just make up any proportion we want. We're not going to find something like HO5. That's just not going to happen. Now, why not? Unfortunately, in any semester, we will occasionally have to say, this is something we'll talk about later on in the course. What we'll need in order to understand exactly why you have to have certain ratios is some idea of why things bond, how they bond, and what sort of rules we have to follow when we're making bonds and breaking bonds to make compounds.